Now it's Friday ataxia, and it can come in exam. It can present like this. Like the command can be, this patient is having a balance problem, kindly examine and do the relevant. Or this patient has balance problem or gait problem, kindly examine the gait or lower limbs. Okay, so because in this actually there is cerebellar sign, so you will start directly from the gait. Or if command is balance problem, again you can start from the gait and then you will come to the lower limbs, or you can start from the lower limbs. Okay, then the command can be, this patient has tremor of the hands, kindly examine the patient and do the relevant. Then start from the upper limb. Okay, and in that case, see the hands, see the tremors for the Parkinson's first, and if it is not there, like you will ask patient to keep the hands in the lap. If it is Parkinsonian tremor, it will be evident, because this is pill rolling resting tremor, and it will be evident when the patient will keep his or her hands in the lap. And when if it is not there, then immediately it should come into your mind that this is cerebral tremor, and you should try to elicit cerebellar sign in the upper limb, because this is 100% diagnostic if you are eliciting cerebellar signs in the upper limb, as I mentioned before, as compared to lower limb. Okay, and as well as you can get a clue from the gait as well. So these are the possibilities by which this case can come in exam, and it can come as a part of spastic paraparesis, and also it can come as a part of cerebellar syndrome. Okay, actually this is a combination of findings, which then we will diagnose the case as a Friedreich ataxia. In remember, in the neurology case, if you say that 100% signs you can find of any disease, then this is not the case. Always there are combination of findings, and if you find major signs, then on the basis of that you can make a list of differential, and then the most likely diagnosis you can conclude. Okay, because I have seen when candidates go in the neurology ward to see the patients, they find a lot, they see lot of patients with multiple findings, mixture of findings overlapping, so they get confused what is the diagnosis and what they read in the book. It's not like that. So in neurology is different from rest of the system, like cardiology, gastroenterology and respiratory. Here you can find combination of findings, and some signs may be overlapping, and if you have a grip on relevant diagnosis and you know what specific signs fall into each disease diagnosis, then you can make a list of diagnosis, a safe list of differential diagnosis, and then you can conclude your diagnosis. Okay, so in Friedreich ataxia, again there are combination of findings. Here you will find cerebellar sign, and it will be bilateral. There will be young patient, okay, less than 30 years of age, and bilateral cerebellar signs along with pyramidal type of weakness of the lower limb. Like I will explain you what is pyramidal weakness, and with peripheral neuropathy. Okay, this suggests a diagnosis of Friedreich ataxia along with pes cavus in the foot and kyphoscoliosis and high arched palate. Okay, these are the again clues to the Friedreich ataxia, and in it you can find a hearing aid. Patient is wearing hearing aid. Also you can palpate a pacemaker in the chest, because patients can have hypertrophic cardiomyopathy. Anyway, this finding, this on inspection what to see, this I'll tell you after some time. First I will tell you how to present your case. Now again, if the command is examine the upper limb, examine the lower limb. If it is examine the upper limb, then again you will find cerebellar signs and you will present as cerebellar signs. Okay, and if command is lower limb, you can find spastic paraparesis, and then you will present your case like that. So now we'll present separately, and whatever you find in your case, you can mix, you can alter, you can manipulate, you can adjust according to that. Now if we are presenting the lower limb, so we will present like this. I will like to complete my examination by checking urine dipstick for glycosuria and examining the eyes, hearing and cardiovascular system for hypertrophic cardiomyopathy. Now this four things I mentioned, out of these four things if you remember two things, then that will be enough even, okay. And if in an exam anxiety if you forgot all of four things, then also it's okay, but it's better at least you should mention two things, okay, from diabetes, optic atrophy, hypertrophic cardiomyopathy and sensory deafness. At least two you should mention, that I will like to complete my examination, okay, by doing this what I mentioned. On examination of the lower limb, I found that patient is having pes cavus and there is wasting, and he is having upper motor neuron type of weakness of the lower limbs as evidenced by extensor plantar response, however reflexes are absent. On examination of the sensory system, there is impaired vibration and proprioception sensation, and there is impaired heel sheen test. This was for the lower limb examination, all, okay. Now you if you get the upper limb examination, then you can present like this, that again I will like to complete my examination, this you will say, and I found that there is wasting, and patient is having this dystochokinesia, impaired finger nose testing and intention tremor. So this is all for the upper limb, no need to go into details because you have to do the relevant. Now anyway, now I am presenting, I will explain after some time. So and when he asked to walk, on examination of his gait, I found that he was ataxic, his gait was broad based. If you can find even high steppage gait as well, so you can mention that if it is there. So and Romberg's test is positive, okay. So then in the eyes you can find nystagmus, simple you can say nystagmus, don't go for broken pursuit and saccades. If you can mention, okay, that's very good, if you can remember, you can memorize, you can reproduce. But if you cannot, then you can simple say nystagmus, because there are a lot of things you have to elicit to make the diagnosis of Friedreich ataxia, okay. So this was about Friedreich ataxia. Now I will tell you what to see on inspection, like if you get a command, examine the lower limb, whatever. So in case of Friedreich ataxia, the command you got, this I have told you before. Now what you can see on examination of the lower limb, you can see wasting, you can see pes cavus in the patient I am talking about, okay. And if you come up, then you can find a hearing aid, because as patients are having, can have 10% sensory deafness, and optic atrophy in the UK, such patients are having white stick. Now that could be present near the patient, could not be. And you can, on palpation anyway, you will feel the pacemaker, you can feel pacemaker if it is there. And along the patient again, you can find in the eyes nystagmus, you can see in the back eye for scoliosis, you can see high arched palate, and along the patient you can find patient orthoses or foot spots, and as we are finding for the pes cavus, as I have mentioned two times before, okay. So these are all things which you will find on inspection. Now what relevant you have to do, like if you find command is examine lower limb and you have found that there is spastic paraparesis, like there is pyramidal type of weakness in it. Pyramidal type of weakness is upper motor neuron type of weakness, okay. And what happens in pyramidal type of weakness, in the lower limb flexion is weaker than extension, while in the upper limb extension is weaker than flexion. That's why in the stroke patient you see it, that in the upper limb their hands, upper limbs are in the flex position, because this is characteristic of pyramidal type of weakness, which is upper motor neuron damage, that flexors are stronger in the upper limb while weaker in the lower limb, okay. And so you will find pyramidal type of weakness, and in the lower limb spastic paraparesis, same as a part of pyramidal weakness, and impaired heel shin test as a part of cerebellar syndrome you will find, and sensory system is affected. You will find depends upon impaired vibration and proprioception sensation. Now these three things you have found in the lower limb, cerebellar signs, pyramidal weakness and impaired sensations. And because of impaired sensation, like involvement of sensory system, the reflex, lower limb reflexes will be absent, but plantar will be extensor because of pyramidal weakness. So now you have find three big clues in the lower limb: pyramidal type of weakness, cerebellar syndrome and impaired sensory system. So combination of these finding along with pes cavus should come into your mind that this patient could have friedreich ataxia. Now you want to confirm your diagnosis 100%. Now what relevant you can do, it depends upon the time how much you have. Now I will give you the list of things which you can do, how much time you have, and you can make your diagnosis of friedreich ataxia, or at least you can make a good differential. After finishing lower limb, now you can ask patient to walk and you can examine the gait. That can be again diagnostic and characteristic. And how will be the gait, this I have told you. Okay, now you can examine the upper limb quickly for the cerebellar sign. Okay, and you can find cerebellar sign that will confirm again that patient is having cerebellar. And in this case, patient will have bilateral cerebellar sign. And then what else you can do? You can check the patient's speech, or you don't check patient's speech, because in this case, cerebellar signs you have listed in the lower limb and upper limb. So now this is confirmed that your patient is having cerebellar syndrome. So if you examine speech, that will further help, but there will not be much time in the exam to elicit the cerebellar speech. So I think you can omit this step, and then quickly check in the eyes nystagmus. Again, it depends upon nystagmus and speech if you get time, because it will, if nystagmus is there, again it will show that patient is having cerebellar disease, and this already you know from the lower limb and upper limb examination, so you can omit even that also. But I am telling you all the points. So what else you could see quickly, you will examine the back for kyphoscoliosis. You can ask patient, can you open your mouth please and look for high arch palate, and examiner will be knowing that you are looking for all of these signs and friedreich ataxia is in your mind. That's why you are looking this. Have a look at the ears, as telling examiner that you are looking for hearing aid, and then palpate the chest for any pacemaker, and you can auscultate even don't auscultate, just palpate for the evidence of pacemaker, okay. And you can see the finger for insulin prick marks. So like this you will make your diagnosis of friedreich ataxia. Hopefully I have explained everything, and now you can make, and now you do, how now you know how it presents, and if it comes in the exam, what relevant you have to do, okay. And please spare 1 minute in the end to do the relevant examination, because only then you can find, you can get 20 out of 20 marks, okay. So and this is autosomal recessive condition, okay. And what else you should know, there are a lot of questions are written, but I don't think so, these you should know, because only DDA or depressed knee and ankle jerk with extensor plantar, it will come again in the spastic paraplegia. So if you don't read from here, then it's okay. And then how you will manage the patient? Again, your answer should be, my management include journal and specific. And journal, as we have explained, as we know, and the specific management, again you can explain. Okay.
Please like, share and subscribe my YouTube channel for more videos. Thank you.